can sing it for you. Let's start with this young man right here. It's probably hard to tell, but he's the youngest guy in the group. Yeah, and he is a wonderful Christian man, has a wonderful family. His father is a minister. If we let him go, he'd start preaching too. And he loves the Lord, loves gospel music. Please make welcome from Southgate, Brian Fuson. Don't you just love old people? Jack joined the group. Actually, Jack and Brian joined the group at the same time. Brian had sung with us several years earlier, and then he came back. When he did, he brought this guy with him. Now this, Jack, is Brian's father-in-law. So, Brian has to be nice to him. Man, it really does. But this guy's been singing as long as I have, and he and I have been singing since we were children. So that goes back, what, 15 years? goes back a long way, but what I'm happy about is when we were singing the praises of the Lord when we were children, now we're still singing the praises of the Lord. That's right. All the way from Wyandotte, Michigan, Mr. Jack Sevens.
Oh, sang a song since probably, let's see, 1974, actually. And the song means a lot to me. Back then, 74, if any of those that are here that can remember, that was a time where things were kind of, you know, shortage of gasoline and stuff like that. And we found out that there was no shortage of God's love back then. I've seen all things through my life. I'm getting to the point where I know I'm closer to heaven now than I ever have been. And I'm thankful that I have had Jesus in my heart for a long, long time, that I don't have to worry about everything that's in this world. And I know being a human being, you do think about things, and like this COVID-19 thing that's been going on, and the government, what's going on, and what's happening in some of our cities, and you think, you know, is it all going to get worse? The Bible teaches that it will. And yet, when you see all that happening, keep your eyes to the sky, because Jesus is coming soon, and he's coming soon a whole lot sooner than when I first started singing. And I believe that he's coming soon. And one day, I won't ever have to worry about nothing ever again. Listen to the words of the song. Anymore.
just sounds sweeter all the time from a child of God. And the longer that we live and the longer that we're saved and we know the Lord, heaven just gets to be a place that we look forward to more than we look forward to being down here. And there's a lot of good things on this earth for me. I'm thankful for the blessings of God in my life. I've got a great wife at home. I've got two little girls, one that's 2 years old, one that's 1 year old. And they are a handful, to say the least. But they're a blessing, and I love them. But I'm looking forward to the day when I get to cross over to the other side and spend eternity with the one who died for me. I'm thankful this morning for the message of the cross. I'm thankful for what the Lord Jesus Christ did for us. And we ought to never get to a place where we don't reflect on Calvary and the sacrifice that Jesus made for us. That it would be possible for us one day to know Him. I'm glad that the Bible still says in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world." We think about that. We've memorized that verse. We've known it all our lives, some of us, since the time when we were little children. But to think about the fact that God so loved the world. If you think about those five words, you'll realize that there's nobody in the world that God doesn't love. There's nobody in the world who isn't significant in the eyes of God. And He so loved us that He gave His only Son to die on the cross for our sins. I'll never be able to understand the cross as to why God could allow His Son to die for you and for me. I'll never understand that love. I wouldn't be able to give one of my children for anyone. Not going to do it. But He loved you and me so much that He gave Jesus for us. And you know, when we think about the cross, those Roman soldiers nailed Jesus. All that held Him there were three nails. But it wasn't so much the nails that were holding on to Him. He was holding on to the nails. When He cried from the cross, He said, "Father, let this cup pass from me, but nevertheless not my will, but Thine be done." I'm glad that He didn't let go of those nails for me and for you. Here's a song that paints a beautiful story of the cross. And it blesses my heart like never before. It says He wouldn't let go.
Standing by 10,000 strong, they just stood at
people that like quartet singing, they want to hear two things. They want to hear the bass go low.
Sports in general will put you in a bad mood these days. But
But I heard this song again, and I listened to the words, and it just absolutely hit me like a ton of bricks. Now, I brought this song to the guys. I said, guys, we need to sing this song. And when we practiced it, most of the time when we learn a song for the first time, it's, you know, you're kind of just feeling it out, kind of trying to see if you like it. The first time we ever sang this song, the Holy Spirit just entered the room. And we knew we had to do this song. I don't know of any song that's a perfect fit for the times in which we live in. The last 4, almost 5 months have probably been some of the most difficult days some of us have ever lived through. And we see all the division in our nation. Whether it's political, whether it's over health issues. And a lot of people are really desperate. And they're looking for some kind of hope. They're looking at their leadership, whether it be in Lansing, whether it be in Washington. I believe there's good people in Lansing. I believe there's good people in Washington. That's not where my hope lies. My hope is not in my financial security. My hope is not in anything that I can do. But my hope is in the one who did it all for me, and his name is Jesus Christ. And that's the message that Washington, Michigan, all our surrounding communities in the world needs to know. That all the hope of the world lies in Jesus Christ. He is our hope. As New Destiny Quartet, we stand here this morning to tell you that all our hope is in Jesus.
Oh,
yes, I have. But I've been freed and forgiven, and I'm not going back, cause I'll never be the same. That's why I sing, all I hope is in Jesus. And thank God my yesterday's gone, and all my sins are forgiven, and I've been washed by the blood. Sing it with us if you know. And all my hope is in Jesus. And thank God.
Joe sings a hymn of the church.
about the last year or so. And we are currently in the studio working on a brand new project. This song is going to be on it. A couple of the songs that we sing have been written by Jack's nephew, Jake. He's an anointed songwriter, lives in the Nashville area. He wrote this song about 4 or 5 years ago. And it's a little bit different than anything we sing, but it's a message we believe in. There is this, started to be this phenomenon that went around in our culture where people didn't want to stand up for the national anthem. And it became something that's really become divisive in our country. No matter what side of the aisle you're on, there's people that believe it's a justified time to protest. And I believe in the right to protest, but I also believe this, that America is the great nation it is because of the men and women who've sacrificed their lives on foreign soil and fought for us, that we can have the right to protest things we don't believe in. And Jake was moved to write this song. And it's powerful. And it's one of those songs that states, you know, some people think that to write a song about what you believe in, you have to come off a little preachy, a little bit arrogant. This is a song that we believe states exactly what the facts are and states it in the most kind way. And I don't know how anybody can be offended by this song. I want you to listen, and if you agree with this song, you know how to let us know. Says simply, I will stand. From our Creator, even life and liberty.
give for a love offering for the new Destiny Quartet. And if you're going to make out a check, write it out to them, the new Destiny Quartet. For you that are viewing online, and maybe I had somebody say, well, I didn't bring cash. Listen, if you address it to our PayPal account, and just make sure you earmark it, the new Destiny Quartet will make sure that they get that love offering, even as it comes in this coming week. We're going to pass around, not pass around, but the ushers are going to come and just put a basket in front of you. If you want to give to them, I truly ask that you do that. How many have been blessed this morning? I'm looking forward to the last few songs, and I appreciate you guys coming out. You know, we do something here at Momentum. I'm going to ask you to do. It's a little different than what we normally do. We normally have these guys come up here, and we would gather around you, and we would pray for you. And this past Friday, we actually did this. I was able to pray over our law enforcement and first responders in St. Clair County and our rally in Algonac. And I told everybody there, I want you just to simply extend your right hand. And everybody in that crowd kind of looked at me funny, and I said, listen, there's no power in it except that it shows that we stand with them. And so what I'd like to do is this. I want us to do the same thing. Just extend our right hand, and we're going to pray over the new Destiny Quartet. I'm going to pray that God blesses your ministry and allows the word of God to go forth through what these guys do in their gifting. So, Father, we just thank you, Lord, for this group of men. Lord, we thank you for their hearts. Lord, we thank you for their giftings, Lord, their ministry. And God, I just ask, Lord, just use them in a powerful way in the days to come, Lord, to bring hope and encouragement. And even as what was said, our hope is in you, but they bring it forth in such a way that it can be seen. And so, Father, I just pray that your glory is seen through them, through their gifting, through their talent. And God, just continue, Lord, just allow them, Lord, to bless others, that others might be blessed, a blessing to you. So, Father, we just thank you for them. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm going to tell you real quick that we have some CDs there in the back. I'm going to let you help me out. Our latest CD is called Freedom Forgiven, which is what we're calling our tour this year, Freedom Forgiven. It has on it Telling the World About His Love, One More Time, All My Hope, Little David. We've done almost every song on this project today. Now we have something we put together since this is our 20th anniversary. It's called New Destiny Quartet, The Early Years. So this is a compilation of 22 songs from the first about 10 years of our ministry. This will be a blessing to you. We have a hymns project, As I Surrender All on It, Blessed Assurance, 8 of the Great Hymns of the Church. We have a project called Walk On. Did we do anything for this today? We have Just Didn't Have a Touch, Lord, From You, that My Grandmother Wrote is on here. Joy Comes in the Morning, Testimony, My Tribute, Glory Road. We also have a Christmas CD in the back, and we have a DVD that has 26 songs on it. This is a live performance from our 15th year anniversary. Here's some t-shirts that we have in the back. This says, if you want to help out our group and kind of get our name out there, New Destiny Quartet, established 2000. This one says, I Will Stand, New Destiny Quartet, if you can see it. And we also have we almost sold out last time. No, you can't read it right now. I'm sorry. We almost sold out on our books and Bibles, but we have a small variety of children's books, Bibles. We have a giant the Gaither Homecoming Bible. It sells for $44.99. It's $20 today. Also, we want to tell you real quick that on November 7th, we will be celebrating our 20-year anniversary at the Great Lakes Christian Church, my church, in Warren, Michigan, and it starts at 6 o'clock. The tickets are only $5 in advance, and we have them here today if you'd like to purchase a ticket. Our special guest that night will be, how many people anybody here remember the Cathedral Quartet when the cathedrals were out? There's a few. Well, Danny Thunderberg was their tenor, and he's going to be our special guest. He's really kind of a living legend in gospel music, and I know it's going to bless your heart. So we'd love to see some familiar faces that night and come out and celebrate our 20 years with us. The other thing I want to mention is that if there's anybody that would like to make a $100 donation to our ministry today, we will give you not just six CDs, we'll give you seven CDs, a children's book, a Bible, two t-shirts, the DVD, two tickets to the anniversary concert, and Joe.
Limited time offer, Scott.
And I forgot to mention, our CDs are 3 for $20 or 6 for $40, and you get 7 CDs in the $100 package. We also take credit cards if you'd like to make a credit card purchase. Now let's get back to what I really enjoy.
And just one more thing I wanted to mention.
Yes.
Now, we want you to take our music home with you. We want you to pay for it, first of all. But we want you to take our music home with you, and we offer a guarantee. You buy our music, if you like it, keep it. If you don't like our music, take it and give it to somebody you don't like. They'll either get blessed by it or get annoyed by it. They can give it to somebody they don't like. But we just want to get our music out there. Thank you so much for coming. Also wanted to say, how many of you are on Facebook, social media sites like that? We are on Facebook. Look up New Destiny Quartet. It's the best way to get in touch with our ministry, see what we're up to, and stay updated. And the best way that you can find out what's going on with us, and you can pray for our ministry as well. We're on Instagram, Twitter, all that good stuff. YouTube, you can find our music anywhere. If you like to stream your music on Apple Music or Spotify, things like that, you can find us on there anywhere. If you know people that like good gospel music, good Christian music, tell them about New Destiny Quartet and let them know about our ministry. We'd appreciate that so much. We told you about us being in the studio and that song that we just sang for you, I Will Stand, is going to be on that recording that we're working on. This is another song we've just started singing that is also going to be on that project. And I love this song. We love songs about heaven. And this song is just a great encouragement to me. This year has just been a real interesting year about what's going on for us, but Jack, earlier this year, had two siblings that passed away within a month of each other. Both had health issues, and the Lord saw fit to take them home. And, you know, it's devastating to lose one sibling. And it's even more devastating to lose two so soon. But the wonderful thing to take comfort in as a family is they know where they're at. They're with the Lord. And I'm glad that there's coming a reunion day one day very soon. And we're going to be with them in eternity far longer than we're without them down here. If you have a loved one that you missed this morning, that you know where they're at, here's a song to comfort. Talks about a great reunion day. The dead in Christ will rise through the air. The saints of God will all be there. Then we that remain will be caught up to meet our Lord so fair. Yes. it's true, every bit of it. And I'm thankful for the promises of God, thankful for the promises of His Word that comfort us, to know that this life is not as good as it gets, amen? But there's something better.
That's right.
And we want to do another song. It's an older song. And I'm sure that if you've been in church, you've been raised around gospel music any time, you've heard this song at some point in your life. And I'm glad that we serve a Savior that's worth singing about. There's something about the name of Jesus that when you sing about it, it ministers to folks. And it ministers to anyone who hears the name of Jesus, because there's power in that name. I'm thankful that even the demons tremble at the name of Jesus because of the power of His name. And this is a song that... if you know it, we want you to feel free to sing along with us. It says, Jesus, Jesus, there's something about that name.
Keep your eyes on the prize before you.
a round of applause. Well, I just want to make just a couple announcements. The first announcement is many of you gave to the church in India, the Leopard Church that we've been partnering with now for about 2 years. Just want you to know that provisions have been made, and they did receive some food packets last week and blankets. It's their rainy season, starting to get a little colder there. They will be getting blankets soon. So I want to thank you for your love offering to Leopard Church. Pastor Zeal and the people there want to say thank you to Momentum Christian Church. And then next Sunday, we're going to be meeting here again. We're going to get back into the Gospel of Mark. So listen, we encourage you all to come out. And for you that are at home online, if you want to give to the new Destiny Quartet, just simply earmark that in your PayPal or your check when you send it in. So with that said, we just want to say God bless. Make sure you visit their table in the back there if you're interested in any of their merchandise. And we will see you next Sunday. God bless.